The Home Improvement and Remodeling Show is sponsored by
our show. We're so glad you could be with us today. Today we're going to be talking about plumbing. It's very important, especially during this cold weather, Steve, like
Frozen pipes.
Absolutely. And we have Delta Plumbing with us today. So sit back and get you a piece of paper. You may have some questions that you'll want to Facebook us with later on if you're having some concerns. But we're going to talk to Josh Johnson. He's a vice president, is that correct?
That's right.
Of Delta Plumbing. And we're going to talk to him a little bit about pipes and broken things and stuff like that. So how are you doing today?
I'm doing really good. How are you?
We're great. Tell us a little bit about the history of Delta Plumbing.
We have. Okay. We've been in business since 1974. We have approximately 20 service trucks. We cover about a 60-mile radius outside of the city of Atlanta. We go anywhere from Alpharetta down to Macon.
Wow, and I bet y'all been really busy here lately.
We have. We got a lot of regular customers that give us a call, so we try to keep everybody that calls us as a regular customer.
Well, with the cold weather, I mean, did you have some issues with the cold weather?
Busted pipes. We didn't in particular because we know kind of what to do with them, but I'm sure a lot of the customers don't. Y'all, for your service, they're going to bust at 8 o'clock at night.
Oh, yeah.
So what happens when they bust and most people are gone home for the night?
Well, a lot of times when a pipe busts, of course, it's going to be in the worst place on the inside of the house. A lot of people, they don't know where their main shutoff valve and stuff like that is. So when we go out to a customer's house that does have a freeze break, we'll give them the opportunity to show them where their main shutoff valves are, just in case they do have an emergency.
And y'all do that after hours?
We do.
Because that's when it's going to happen. If something breaks at my house, it's going to be Saturday or 8 or 9 o'clock at night.
That's
so y'all have 24-hour service.
That's right. And the good thing about that is, too, we don't charge any kind of overtime rates or anything like
that.
Wow.
That's great. That's great to know. Well, tell me a little bit. I'm curious because, of course, you're going to have two different opinions here.
Right.
As a female in a household, what is the best protection for cold weather with your pipes like that? What would you suggest? People tell me to open up the cabinets. People tell me, you know, wrap your pipes and stuff.
Leave the water dripping.
You know, if you don't have a man in the house and you don't know what to do, I mean, women out there need to know how to take care of that.
Well, you know, one thing you can do, of course, like you said, just leave a faucet at nighttime. Just leave it barely dripping. If you have constant water running through the pipes, it's going to keep continuous flow. And
it won't freeze.
That's right, it won't freeze.
Really? Is that how
that
works?
Yep.
So if I went outside and my hose had water dripping out of it and it has a little puddle of ice underneath it, that's a bad sign?
That is a bad sign.
Oh, yay! Well, I guess I'll be giving you a call.
I appreciate it.
And another question I was going to ask is, what about, everybody always talks about leaky toilets.
That's right.
Leaky toilets can cost you a lot of money. And if you have a leak in the toilet, y'all fix those.
That's right.
Okay.
And, you know, a couple things that can cause leaky toilets is, of course, bad parts on the inside of the toilets.
Mm-hmm.
You could have too much pressure inside your house. It could cause those toilets to run. And we take care of all that.
Now, a lot of people are remodeling their houses. And
That's
part
right.
of it is the bathroom.
That's right.
The newer fixtures, which I'm sure y'all carry a full line of
we
fixtures
do.
And stuff.
We do. We carry everything from Kohler to American Standard. We keep top-of-the-line parts. You know, once we install a fixture for a customer, we don't ever want to have to go back to replace
right.
it. So we want to put
Use
a
good
high
stuff.
Grade. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. That's what we're all about.
Now the newer toilets and all are more efficient. Don't they use less water
they
than
are.
Like an older one?
A while back, they used to have 3.25 gallon per flush toilets.
Mm-hmm.
They swapped over to the 1.6 gallons. Here shortly, they're actually going to eliminate the 1.6. Everybody's going to have to swap over to the 1.25 gallon toilets.
Uh-oh.
So not near as much water usage.
No,
that's
sir.
The whole concept
no,
of conserving the water.
They're redesigning their systems to where they flush better. Everybody was worried about, you know, with them going to a lower flush toilet, it's not going to flush.
Is it going to flush everything down?
Oh, yes, sir. Yes, sir. And they actually give a rebate through the Water Authority if you swap over to the 1.25 gallon flush
toilet. Well, that's good news.
Yes, sir.
Steve's concerned about his flush.
Absolutely.
Oh, my God.
Well, I remember when my children were young, they would throw things in the toilet.
Oh, my goodness,
So we
Steve.
Needed it to flush good so it would go on out. We wouldn't have to call Josh.
That's funny, Steve. But your children are older now.
Yes.
So they
yes.
know better. Okay.
I hope they're not throwing things down the toilet.
Yeah,
now.
Me too. That would be scary. But now, with I found out recently, we've done some research with our show, and what's the percentage of the homes here in Henry County?
I heard like 80% of
on
the homes
septic?
In Henry County
are
on
right.
septic tanks.
That's right. Yes, sir, they
That's
are.
A huge amount.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
It's one of the things that y'all specialize in coming out.
We do specialize in septic tank service. We do have a Delta Rooter and Septic division of our company. You know, we'll come out, we'll service and pump your tank. We'll also treat it with enzymes, install risers. We try to set the customer up on a service maintenance plan. So if we come back out to their property, we can look at their septic tank and make sure it's in good working order for them.
How often should you have a septic tank pump?
Generally, depending on how many people you have, you generally want to get it done every 4 years.
Every 4 years.
That's correct. Every 4 years.
Okay, well, what we're going to do, we're going to take our first commercial break. We have some great questions to come back and ask him, more questions about septic tank, because that can really be super expensive, and there's a lot of things that you're going to want to look out for. So stay tuned, and we'll be right back.
Mom, it's the toilet again.
Don't worry, just call Delta Plumbing for speedy 24-hour service. At Delta Plumbing, we can handle all of your plumbing troubles. Our licensed and bonded technicians will assess your problem and find the right solution for you. For all your plumbing needs, call Delta Plumbing. Another job well done by Delta.
My Kids Tumble Bus, a gym on wheels, is a magical adventure of fun and fitness where wishes come true. At birthday parties, preschool academies, or daycares, we help your kids have a great time enjoying the fantastic sports of gymnastics. Our new Dance and Cheer Bus will bring the fun and joy of dance and cheerleading to your kids as well. Call My Kids Tumble Bus today.
Hello, I'm Steve Nail, president of Nail Heating and Air Conditioning. Comfort and peace of mind. With Nail Heating and Air Conditioning, you get certified drug-free workers, a lifetime warranty on your installations, and a 100% satisfaction guarantee. We can design the perfect indoor comfort environment for you. Clean air, humidity control, lower bills. You can't lose. Call today for your free in-home estimate. Simple, worry-free comfort from someone you trust. Nail Heating and Air Conditioning.
It's the most unique, fun-filled daycare and learning center in Atlanta. Get on board Noah's Ark, the daycare shaped like a giant boat. Noah's Ark Daycare and Learning Center provides your child loving care and a secure environment. Surveillance cameras monitor virtually every move in all classrooms and playground, and the atmosphere is designed for fun and excitement. But Noah's Ark can also help your child get a head start on their educational development with the Abeka curriculum. So get on board Noah's Ark.
There are immediate openings for infants K-3 and K-4, but space is limited, so call today.
Party Time has a new location, the McDonough Square. You've helped to make us the number one party store in the area, and we'd like to encourage you to come on by our new location on the McDonough Square. A new location, hundreds of new items, and we've added a party room for rentals for your convenience. Whether you're having a party for children, church, work, the big game, a shower, or whatever, Party Time, the fun place, has everything you need under one roof. Or you can rent our party room. Come see what all the fuss is about. Now on the McDonough Square, Party Time, the fun place.
Rehab Technologies has been serving Henry County since 1992, providing exceptional service and quality products. We pride ourselves on offering our customers education as well as matching the right products for patients. Our 2,000 square foot retail showroom will provide you with the products you need. Our goal is to provide you service and education and for our clients to gain independence, mobility, and comfort. Come visit us at 3200 Highway 42 North in Stockbridge.
Reiner's is a locally owned full-service appliance dealer and servicer that has been serving Henry County and the metro Atlanta area with all of their appliance needs for more than 30 years. At Reiner's, we inventory a full line of major name brand appliances on dishwashers, dishwasher and dryers, ovens, cooktops, refrigerators, and freezers. We handle all of your appliance needs, including sales, service parts, and installation. Call or come visit our showroom today or visit reinersinc.com. Remember, at Reiner's, we're not satisfied until you are.
Hi, welcome back to our show. Josh had a question. I was in a house one time that the water line from the street to my house busted.
Right.
And they had to come and they dug up pretty much half my front yard and they had to replace that pipe. I understand you guys have some technology where that doesn't have to happen now.
That's right. We try to stay up to date on all the new technology that pertains to plumbing. We actually have what they call trenchless technology, which is a horizontal directional bore machine. What it does, it drills up underground from the meter to whatever point we're going to inside the house where the water line enters the house. And, you know, we don't have to tear up anything.
You don't have to dig the big trench, bring the big tractor and dig up half my yard. And
no, sir. And a lot of times what will happen, a lot of water lines run up under concrete slabs.
Right.
And that would be the perfect scenario to use the bore machine.
You go up under it.
Yeah,
you don't have to bust up the concrete.
Yeah, normally where your water line comes up, it comes directly out of the slab.
Right.
So we would, you know, jackhammer a 12 by 12 hole. We would bore the water line from the meter directly to that point. And like I said, we wouldn't have to disturb any of the yard or anything like that.
Now, I had a quick question because is it possible with that technology that you have the ability that to show a televised option of what you're actually, you
video.
Can actually video it and
video.
You can see it before you even do any work?
We do. What happens is, and that's pertaining to the sewer lines.
Okay.
What we do if a customer had a sewer line, you know, of course, we would come out there, we would unstop it, we would run our TV camera down it. At that point in time, we would locate where in the yard we have a problem. Because a lot of times customers have irrigation lines, you know, sodded yard, nice flower beds. I mean, we don't want to come out there and tear up their yard.
Just tear everything up.
Because that's just extra cost that they have
to incur. So the video camera, you can actually isolate where the problem is.
I can isolate exactly where the problem is.
You know where to go dig.
That's right. From point A to point B, we'll get it replaced, and you'll never know we were there.
Wow. And so that's with the sewer line, not the septic tanks.
Right.
Okay, because I'm trying to figure out, you know, of course, the difference in both.
You hear everybody,
it's just not something that women do. So.
but you hear a lot about septic tanks, and with
that's
Henry
right.
County, 80% of the homes being on septic tanks.
That's right.
What exactly is a septic tank? What does it do,
How does
Josh?
It work?
Well,
yeah.
What a septic tank does, of course, you got your sewer line coming from the house to the septic tank. The sewer line is actually a two-part tank. Okay, it's actually what they got. They have a baffle inside the tank, and what it does, it separates the water from the solids. So you open the lid on the first part of your septic tank, you have all the solids, toilet paper, and that kind of thing.
Ew.
Yeah, so what it does, the septic tank actually filters all that, and by the time it gets out into the drain field, it's nothing but water by the time it gets out into the drain
What
field.
Happens to all the other stuff? Does it just
Well, it accumulates in the first part of the tank.
That's
the septic tank's job. The first part is to catch all the solids.
Right.
The second part, by the time it gets there, it's pretty much solidified. It's water, and it goes out into your drain field.
It just drains out?
Yes, sir.
And it goes and gets treated.
Well, that's right.
Okay.
What happens to those solids? Is there something that eats it? You see these commercials with the little...
Right. There's actually bacteria in the bottom of the tank. A lot of times, you know, we'll go out and we'll pump a septic tank.
Right.
You actually need to leave approximately 4 or 5 inches of bacteria at the bottom of the tank. So it does eat down those solids that are in the first part of the tank.
Wow, do I feel like I'm sitting by micro?
Now, I've seen advertisements where they say, put this down in your tank or flush it down your commode. It
That's
helps
right.
promote to...
Yep, every
does
time...
Does that work? Does that stuff work?
It does. What you need to do, you need to treat your septic tank once a year.
Right.
They have different things you can buy. Of course, everybody knows Red-X, which
right.
is a good thing
I
to use.
I thought that was a monthly thing, though. Is it monthly or once
they
a year?
They have two things. They have the once-a-year treatment, and then, you, of course, you have your monthly treatment that you can use.
Okay.
Like I said, Red-X is a good product.
And it's very important to use that, huh?
Very important. Very important.
Let me ask you this, Josh. Is there... I know we offer maintenance on air conditioners.
That's right.
Do y'all offer like maintenance where if somebody just don't want to mess with that, I don't want to do with it.
We do.
I want to hire a professional to come assure me.
Right.
I don't want to do with it.
On the initial visit when we come out, of course, what we would like to do, we're going to say, hey, you know, we can maintain this system. What we need to do is install risers on your septic tank, which of course are access lids.
Okay.
So you don't have to dig up your tank every time.
Wow.
The tanks can be pretty big, right?
That's right. They're normally, you know, 10 by 6 or something like that. So when you dig it up, you're going to have a, you know, big mess
big
in
hole.
Your yard.
Ooh, mess in your yard.
And a stinky mess.
Yep. So when we come back the second time, you know, we want to have those risers on there, of course, so we can just pop a lid, check everything and say, hey, you're in good working order until next time.
Wow. Now,
just
what
like
is
an access port.
That's right. Yes, sir.
I was just curious. With that being said, what is the average life expectancy of a septic tank as long as you're maintaining it? Is it good forever, or do you replace it over time?
Well, they say the normal life expectancy is 20 years because, I mean, everybody doesn't, you know, pump their tanks and stuff like that.
Ooh,
like they should. But you need to pump your tank every 4 years.
I'm beginning
well,
to
what
learn
happens if
a
don't?
Lot.
Say I don't.
Well, if you don't pump your tank, what happens? All those solids, they build up in the tank.
All those toys that go down your
all
toilet
toys,
will come up out of the yard.
Toys.
All the solids that go out in the drain field, of course, cause blockage in your drain field, ooh, which 9 times out of 10, which will need a replacement.
That's expensive. That
yes, sir. It runs anywhere between $5,000 to $6,000.
That is some great information because I live in an older home.
Right.
I've moved into an older neighborhood to be next to my mother, and I'm going to have to look into my tank and make sure it's being maintained properly because the house is older than 20 years. Okay, so we need to take our other break.
We're ready.
We're ready to take our other break. So what we're going to do is when we come back, he's got some specials he's going to talk to you about. So stay tuned. We'll be right back.
You know, the original Rib Shack, we still handwrite our orders, you know, but we're going to stay that down-home, great place to come where you feel like things don't change. But some of our employees even know when a customer calls in on the phone, they even know their name by their voice. But our staff embodies what we believe, and that's about taking care of customers. And our customers come to really expect a lot more because of that. And that's the other thing about our food. It's real. It embodies exactly what we started out to do. And it's just real food for a great experience.
Hello, this is Ken Yancey with Sinorama right here in McDonough. In today's competitive business world, name recognition is everything, and that's where we come in. Here at Sinorama, our team of trained professionals can help you create the image that you deserve and help you get the business that you should have. It doesn't matter if it's a banner, if it's a business card, or if it's a yard sign. We can help you create the design that you'll need and that you can use to help bring you more business in. And remember, a business with no sign is a sure sign of no business.
Hello, I'm Dr. Barry Dix, a cardiologist with Southern Heart Specialists. Southern Heart Specialists has been the premier provider of cardiovascular care to South Atlanta for over 30 years. From our humble beginnings, we have expanded to 13 board certified specialists. While we continue to advance, our core values remain the same. At Southern Heart Specialists, we are committed to providing you and your loved ones the very best cardiovascular care. It is this philosophy that has made Southern Heart the area's leading provider of cardiovascular care since 1975.
Southern Patio is a quality outdoor furniture and accessory store, family owned and operated since 2005. From grills, supplies, outdoor accessories, sunsetter awnings, furniture repair and more, you'll find everything you need to turn your backyard into outdoor fun and relaxation. Our knowledgeable staff is second to none, offering you friendly customer service and recommendations for your outdoor patio. We also provide a complete line of decorative concrete to enhance any part of your home. So visit our showroom on Highway 42 North in McDonough. Southern Patio, where outdoors is in.
Got scrap metal, aluminum, old radiators, or batteries laying around? Turn that scrap into cash at Stockbridge Recycling Center on Highway 42 North. We take everything from brass, copper wires, aluminum cans, water heaters, old grills, and so much more. Come in and turn that old scrap into cash. Call 770-474-2621 or drop by today.
Last year was our best year ever, and to celebrate, we're rolling out new Chick-fil-A sandwiches, Big T burgers, and other delicious items. Hi, I'm Billy Thompson, and I'd like to invite you to come by Truett's Grill and taste drive one of our brand new Chick-fil-A sandwiches. delicious Big T burgers, or try one of our delicious hand-spun milkshakes. We're overstocked and ready to meal and deal. So come on by Truist Grill, located on Jonesboro Road, exit 221, west of I-75 in McDonough.
You can receive a text or email when you get a package from the UPS store. Another reason why small business loves logistics.
You know, the price of gold fluctuates daily. How can you get top dollar? Well, bring that unwanted gold or silver to We Buy Gold and Silver. Trusted for over 35 years with family-owned businesses locally here in Henry County, they'll give you top dollar for your gold or silver. Do you want new flooring? Visit Atlanta Designer Flooring, sister to We Buy Gold and Silver, and you can trade your gold for that new floor you've always wanted. Stop by their showroom off Jotico Road in the Gadsden Village Shopping Center, or visit them online for more details.
Summer's just around the corner, and with the help from Above Ground Pros, you can beat the heat and provide some fun in the sun. We offer complete packages starting as low as $1,750. For the cost of a typical family vacation, you can have a vacation in your backyard every summer for the next 20 years. So invite us to your home for a free backyard estimate. For pool sales, installation, services, or liner replacements, call Above Ground Pros today or find packages and product information on the web at AboveGroundPros.com.
Hello, I'm Jerry Poole, owner of Affordable Dock and Door, your Broken Springs experts, located in Henry County since 1994. Our expert technicians are ready to meet all your residential and commercial needs. We give free estimates and are licensed and insured. We install and repair all types of garage doors and openers and have same-day service in most cases. Don't delay. Call us today at 770-957-9400 or visit us at affordabledoorsnow.com.
There's nothing more relaxing than watching a fire in a fireplace or grilling out in your backyard. If you're looking for a clean and efficient way to do that, then All About Gas is the place to stop. A family-owned Christian-based business with over 70 years of combined experience, All About Gas has everything from fireplaces, gas logs, outdoor grills, gas lights, stoves, gas, wood, and pellet, and more. Easy and convenient, our staff will answer any questions you have about gas appliances and help you through sales, installation, and service. They're all about you, and they're all about gas.
It's the GM Open House at Bellamy Strickland, where new cars and trucks are being sold at supplier discount. The price you see is the price you pay, and receive up to 0% long-term financing and rebates up to $4,000. And don't miss out on Pontiacs at closeout pricing. So come visit us for this summer event at Bellamy Strickland Chevrolet, Pontiac GMC, and Buick in McDonough.
At Delta Plumbing, we know when it comes to your water heater, you want fast, dependable service. That's why we use high-quality Rheem water heaters, a name you can trust. Our dispatchers send out trained professionals to assess your water heater needs and repair or replace your unit. And after we're done, we'll take your old one when we go. Delta Plumbing is licensed and bonded, and we can get to most jobs that same day. Delta Plumbing, the skills you need, the experience you can trust.
The Home Improvement and Remodeling Show is sponsored by
our show. We are having a fantastic time talking to Josh Johnson of Delta Plumbing about a lot of educational information that you may be interested in regarding plumbing. And now, Steve, during break, we were talking about finishing basements and some questions that he had about water heaters. So,
I had a friend of mine's going to finish his basement, and he had asked me this last week, is he going to need to install an auxiliary water heater or a separate water heater And I know there's different types out there now. Do y'all, right. y'all carry different, the tankless? I know a lot of people like the tankless.
We do. Actually, we carry Rheem water heaters.
Right.
We carry, of course, the tank water heaters. We also install tankless. Like you said, when you install a bathroom in your basement, a lot of times in your house, your water heater that you have only services your plumbing fixture. So you probably would need to upgrade that water heater.
Well, what's the difference in the water heater and the tankless water heater?
Well, of course, the tank water heater, of course, it's got the igniter on the bottom. It has to heat up all the time. So every time that you turn on a faucet, you use the hot water out of the tank, it has to be reheated.
Okay.
With a tankless water heater, it's on-demand hot water. It doesn't have to keep heating up, so you save on your gas and power use.
Is there a difference? I mean, is there a particular benefit as far as having a tankless for the size? Some people have large families. They use
right.
water all the time. Is it a benefit to do that versus having just a regular water heater that you would only use every once in a while?
It is. With a tankless water heater, the way it works, if you have a family of six, kids go to baseball practice, everybody's getting home from work needing to take showers.
They won't take it at the same,
time.
Yep, everybody yep. taking it at the same time. Once the hot water gets there, you'll never run out of hot water.
Wow.
So. What is the average life expectancy of a standard water heater? Say I've got a water heater, I've been in my home 15, 20 years.
Okay.
Is that realistic? I mean, when should you replace it? And y'all do that?
If
my water heater went out in my house, the
yes,
existing
sir.
Water heater, you guys could come yep. and install a new one?
We do. The normal life expectancy of a water heater is 8 years.
Wow.
A lot of people don't understand that you need to service and drain your water heater once a year.
Oh, really?
Oh, yeah.
Do y'all do that?
We do.
Say, I don't want to mess with that. That's something I don't want to mess with.
He doesn't like doing anything.
That's you guys.
Are you getting that, Josh?
I don't want to do it.
That's where the maintenance plan comes into play. If we set you up on a maintenance agreement.
That's something y'all
wow.
cover.
Yes, sir. We'll come out to your house once a year, drain it down for you, and make sure it's in
and work. That'll help prolong the life of
yeah.
the water heater?
Yeah, because what happens, a lot of people don't understand, there's a lot of sediment from the water coming in from the city and the county.
Wow.
It sits in the bottom of your tank, so
mm-hmm.
if you don't flush it out on a normal daily basis, then all that'll sit there and it'll rust out the tank of your water heater.
Mess it up. Do y'all, what would that run me? Do y'all
actually, we got
put
a
put in a water heater?
Yep. Actually, we have a special right now. It's $5.99 for a 40-gallon water heater.
Wow.
And that's installation
that's
everything?
Installation.
Is it tankless or regular?
That's the regular tank water heater.
Okay.
For a tankless, we would need to come out, of course, give a free consultation. Everybody's house is set up differently.
Okay.
So
y'all do give free estimates?
We give free estimates.
Okay,
yes,
that's good to know.
Free consultation day or night.
Right.
So.
Right.
Wow, that's a lot of great information. And I mean, we're learning so much about plumbing, and I'm learning so much about you, how you like to not do a whole lot.
I don't, well, if I don't have to.
Well,
yeah.
We can take care of
they're the professionals.
Yeah. Well, is there any other special information that you would like to share with our viewers? This has been a very good educational show.
Appreciate
is there anything else that you would like to share with us about Delta Plumbing? And
yeah, like I said, just keep in mind, give us a call day or night if you have a plumbing emergency. That's 10 o'clock at night. We charge same rates at 10 o'clock at night than we do at 10 o'clock in the morning, so just keep us in mind for all your service needs, and we'll take care of you the best of our ability.
Wow.
Great.
Well, I tell you what, we really appreciate you being with us today. This has been a lot of great information, and thank you so much. So
no
y'all remember, are y'all on Facebook?
We are on Facebook.
Okay.
Delta Plumbing on Facebook.
And
yes,
what
ma'am.
About your website?
It is deltaplumbingga.com.
I know that if you have some questions or more information that you would like to know, you can go to their website or give them a call, and I'm sure they'll be more than happy to answer anything that you may have, especially during this time of the year. And with it being so cold, and you've got that issue too, with heating and air.
Yes.
You've got some crazy
yes.
things going on. But we have really enjoyed you being a part of our show today. And remember, if you have any questions about home improvement or remodeling that you would like for us to address, you can find me on Facebook. I have a public page, and Steve has one as well.
Absolutely. Nail, heating, and air.
So just give us a holler there, or either you can call the studios if you're interested in being featured as well on our show. And thank you so much for tuning in today.